From North Brunswick, New Jersey, welcome to the finals of the 2009 MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee.
Over the last 2 months, we've been busy conducting the search for our champion. The path began with spellers registering themselves to participate at the regionals, and from there, the top two winners became finalists. In all, there were 8 centers that included New Jersey, DC, Dallas, Houston, Chicago, New York, Los Angeles, and the Bay Area. Today, we have with us the winners from each of those centers. So please join me in welcoming the 16 finalists of the 2009 MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee. One more round of applause for these 16 finalists. Now, before we start, let's have a quick look at how we got here tonight.
O-E-T-S-G-O.
That is correct.
It's so exciting to be here tonight, seeing all these 16 finalists on stage. And I'm sitting here with the 2009 Scripps runner-up, all the way from Springfield, Illinois, Aishwarya Pastapur. Aishwarya, welcome to the finals of the South Asian Spelling Bee.
Thanks, Rahul.
Well, Aishwarya, you've been an alumni of the South Asian Spelling Bee last year. You were in these shoes not so long ago, and you were also the runner-up this year. Do you want to go over the rules before we start?
Sure. Well, Rahul, it's pretty simple. The bee is conducted orally on a miss-and-out basis. Basically, if a speller misspells the word, they're out of the competition. During the oral contest, a speller is entitled to ask the pronouncer to repeat the word, to define the word, to use the word in a sentence, to provide the part of speech of the word, and to provide the language or languages of origin of the word. Once the speller is ready, they must repeat the word back before and after spelling the word. Also, once a speller has said a letter in their spelling, they are not allowed to change the letter.
Well, that was fair and simple.